All right, so I pretty much need to get caught up on the new games coming out this year because I missed a bunch of games last year and I don't plan on missing any this year, especially Hogwarts Legacy. Well, I don't know any of the games that are coming out this year, so let's get into it. Let's figure out what's coming out this year and what we need to play.
With Fire Emblem Engage on Switch. This is the follow-up to Three Houses, and this time around you'll be able to summon.
I never played the Fire Emblem games. See, there's a bunch of games I'm ashamed to admit that. I've never played the Fire Emblem games. And I want to. I got a Switch too, so it came out 4 days ago, I think. That's what it's saying.
Or engage characters from the series past, including OG protagonist and Smash staple Marth. You can put a ring on it January 20th, so save the date. If the Callisto Protocol didn't satisfy your need for deep space survival horror in which combat tips are awkwardly written on the wall in blood, well, you can relive the original Dead Space with Dead Space Remake.
That's what I was talking about earlier. This is one of the game. Oh, I said Mass Effect. I meant Dead Space. Oh my God. I need to. Holy shit. So I meant Dead Space, not Mass Effect. Although I've never played Mass Effect either. Never played Dead Space, never played Mass Effect. I need to play both of these games.
The entire game has been recreated painstakingly in the Frostbite engine, and it shakes things up a bit with a disgusting new system, which is called peeling, that apparently lets you mutilate those necromorphs down to the individual bones and tendons. That's horrible. And it's also on new gen and PC on the 27th. On February 10th, it's back to school
Hell,
season in the Wizarding World.
this is the game I've been waiting on. This is the game I fucking, this is the game I want to play so fucking bad. I don't care what game is out. I'm dropping it as soon as Hogwarts Legacy is drops. Like I'm dropping whatever game I'm playing to play Hogwarts Legacy, because I'm a wizard. They call me Erdna. I have a wizard ass name too. I have a fucking great wizard ass name, Erdna, Grand Wizard Erdna. Hell yeah! Shut up. Don't talk to me.
World and Hogwarts Legacy lets you live out the ultimate fantasy of attending Harry Potter's alma mater. Just imagine the thrill of paying out the ass for textbooks that try to bite you, the least wheelchair accessible stairs in the history of school, and your entire academic career being determined by a guidance counselor who is a talking hat. But hey, at least you can re-roll if it puts you in Hufflepuff.
I don't like how he's disrespecting the fuck out of the fucking sorting hat like that. I'm gonna find out who the fuck this is. It's on site.
If you're not totally sick of hearts after eating a box of Valentine's candy while playing Wild Hearts, on the 21st, Atomic Heart can get your
Okay.
blood pumping. This is the single-player first-person shooter with a Soviet aesthetic that looks a bit like Fallout's paleofuturism, but from
What
the
is it
other
like,
side of the
robot
Iron Curtain.
zombies? What would that be? No. There's a word for that. AI takeover?
Combat and weirdness levels seem more in line with BioShock. If you're looking for something to pass the time until Ken Levine's Judas, this might be worth checking out, and it's on everything but Switch. The name Company of Heroes might suggest a sandwich chain like Subway or Quiznos, but rest assured, Company of Heroes 3 is still a World War II RTS. In addition to two unique campaigns in North.
I know Angry Joe is gonna rip this apart. Well, depending on how good it is. When does this come out? All right, next month. Because I know Angry Joe is a fucking. He loves war games and shit. That's based on strategy and movement and whatnot. So, kind of interested to see what his review is.
Northern Africa and Italy, this one also adds new gameplay features like a dynamic campaign map and a tactical pause, which sounds great for when the real-time combat gets a little too real. That comes to PC on February 23rd. Sons of the Forest is the direct descendant of the hit woodland survival game with a heavy emphasis on survival. While a lot of us would prefer to be stuck on a proverbial desert island with a Steam Deck or an attractive celebrity, this one will see you foraging for supplies and braving the elements while also fending off a horrible cave system full of terrifying mutant cannibals. Sounds lovely. That's on PC. If that's too.
Hey, don't they have a game like that already? I think they already have a game like that. I can't remember what it's called.
On March 1st, the day before hits PC, and before your eyes glaze over at the idea of yet another post-apocalyptic zombie survival game with base building and survival elements, get a load of these graphics. A lot of games on this list were.
This should look fire.
Delayed due to the pandemic, but developer Fnatic pushed this one so they could switch engines from Unreal 4 to Unreal 5, and it looks.
This man aim ain't shit. He can't aim for shit.
Like that was a smart move because it's the second most wishlisted game on Steam after Hogwarts Legacy. That's on PC with plenty.
It's come out March 1st. Okay, when does Hogwarts Legacy come out? I fucking missed that. I think it's like February 10th or some shit. Ah, February 10th. Took me forever to fucking get here, but.
Plans for new gen console versions later on. Wolong Fallen Dynasty is the latest project from Team Ninja, and it looks to continue the long tradition of kicking your ass repeatedly, which began with Ninja Gaiden.
This game's gonna be fun too. Oh wait, no. Or am I thinking of the Wukong game? I think I'm thinking of the Wukong game. Wukong.
And the Neo games, but this one's set in China's Three Kingdoms period, but you know, it's got a grisly dark fantasy twist that is on all the stuff that isn't made by Nintendo. Allegedly, Skull and Bones is finally coming out, but I will believe it when I see it. This is Ubisoft's multiplayer pirate game, which supposedly began as an Assassin's Creed Black Flag spinoff, and at one point was apparently like For Honor with boats, but since then it's taken the shape of something much more like Sea of Thieves, and it's been delayed about, well, my entire career. Anyway,
I actually want to play this, because I fucking love Sea of Thieves. Sea of Thieves is cool, For Honor was cool, so if they mix those, if they mesh those perfectly, it's gonna be a good game. I play this. I'm sure me and Cheeto will play this, like, for sure.
That drops Anchor on new gen and PC March 9th, allegedly. Still on March 17th is Star Wars Jedi Survivor, the follow-up to...
This is one of the games I started playing. Oh, I gotta finish this game. Okay, so I think that's what I'm doing. This is gonna be the first game I start playing. I'm starting this game over, and I'm gonna fucking play it through to the completion. Straight story. I'm not gonna worry about side quests or anything, because I need to just finish the game, because I have a big problem with just doing that, so... Star Wars Jedi. I'm excited for this game right here. I'm excited to fucking play. I'm gonna tell you that right now.
The Fallen Order, which sees the return of an older and hairier Cal Kestis who will undoubtedly have some new tricks up his sleeve. Technical hiccups aside, Respawn knocked it out of the park with the first game, so hopefully this continues the streak that is on new gen consoles and PC.
What are you buying?
Well, on March 24th, Resident Evil 4 remake problem.
Yo, okay. Me and Resident Evil 4 have this, like, we have this unique relationship. I've never, ever played it, but I've watched people play the full game multiple times. Like, I'm a backseat gamer when it comes to this game. I love it. Never played it.
Between the recent mainline entries and the last two remakes, Capcom probably hasn't had the trust of fans like this since, well, probably RE4's original release, and a modern remake of one of the best, albeit most divisive games in the entire series, with a few modern adjustments, seems like it'll be a pretty good time. That's on both PlayStations, Xbox Series X, and PC. Crime Boss Rock-Hay City is a brand new first-person shooter that came totally out of left field, and we don't know much about it other than it's got a star-studded cast, which is mostly Michaels and Dan.
It's a Rockstar game? I mean, it looked like it. I have no idea. I'm not saying it is. It was a question.
Anyways, specifically, Rooker, Madsen, Glover, and Trejo. It also has Kim Basinger, Vanilla Ice, and Chuck Norris. What's the gameplay like? Great question. That's on PC March 28th and consoles someday. Before there was Bioshock, there was System Shock, and this is yet another classic that's getting a full modern remake, and if you're having deja vu, that might be because this got kickstarted way back in 2016, and sometime in March, you'll finally get to play it. That's on...
2016? Damn! How long has it been? 6 years? Shit.
Everything that doesn't say Nintendo on it. Dead Island 2 has had a long and rocky development, and on April 28th, it's finally rising from its grave. LA is infested with zombies, and you gotta go kill them. What do you kill them with? All kinds of stuff, including stuff that's glued to other stuff that you glued there on a crafting bench. That's coming out April 28th, once again, on everything but Switch.
I'll play that. If Dead Island 2 is multiplayer, I'm definitely playing that with the boys. That's for damn sure.
But hey, Switch owners are going to be just fine, because on May 12th, Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom finally drops. Breath of the Wild was such a genre-redefining watershed game that the wait for a follow-up has felt like a lifetime, and that might be because this has been one of, if not the longest breaks between Zelda installments in the entire series.
Okay, I only played one Zelda game, and I think that was Majora's Mask. I don't think I played enough Zelda games for me to ever want to play any of the Zelda games. I know they're good. I just probably won't play them. I don't know. We'll see. I don't like to say never, so.
History. So let's hope it lives up to everybody's sky-high expectations. It's been a very long wait for a new game from Rocksteady, the studio that gave us the Batman Arkham series, and while it's set in the same universe, Suicide Squad Kills the Justice League looks to be a pretty huge departure.
This game is going to be way better than the movie. I already know. I can tell.
This time, players can get down with their bad selves as Harley Quinn, Captain Boomerang, King Shark, and or Deadshot. That's on new gen and PC. Street Fighter VI looks to be maybe the biggest shift for the series since its jump from 2 to 2.5D back in Street Fighter IV, but this is much more than just a visual leap. It's adding a character creator and a-
Character creator? That's my shit. If you know me, I fucking love character creation.
For you to explore.
I spent hours in that bitch. I'm the type to go in there to move the fucking eyes and the eyebrows and shit, give them a little wrinkle, but move the look. like give him some character. I'm the type to do all that. My thing is like it's an option. They're letting you choose. They're letting you do this. They're giving you options. They're letting you do it. Why don't you? That's how I feel. It's like a personal challenge. It's like the game developers are challenging me directly to use some of those features, and I do. But again, not a stranger.
And hang out in and presumably do some street fighting in, but don't worry, as far as fighting goes, it's not reinventing the wheel, and the buzz for this among fighting game diehards seems very positive. That's on PS4, PS5, Series X and S, and PC. Diablo 4 has been in the works for a very long time, but it sounds like it's going to be worth the wait. With a color palette that's far more in line with Diablo 2 than 3, it is a clear return to proper dark fantasy, and its gorgeous world is wide open for you to explore while slaying demons and hoarding loot. That's out on 6/6 for everything but...
June 6th, I need to put that in my calendar. Me and Matt was playing Diablo 3, and we crushed that fucking game. Like, we crushed it. We didn't get as far as we could have, nowhere near as far as we could have, but we made it a long way to the point where we was, like, overpowered in, like, the craziest places. All right.
Switch. Like many other games on this list, Final Fantasy 16 is a massive departure from its immediate predecessor. This time, it's scrapping the futuristic element.
Never played it.
Moments and returning to good old-fashioned medieval fantasy, and if you're tired of open worlds, rest assured this looks to have a much more focused area-based approach to level design, but combat is still going to be in real time. That one's exclusively on PS5 for the immediate future. This will undoubtedly be a real showcase of what the Series S and X are capable of graphically, and those sexy anime ladies you plastered all over your tricked-out Subaru will look sexier than ever. And so will the Super.
What is he talking
That's
about?
On Series X and S and PC sometime in the spring. Fans of Homeworld 2 have been waiting 2 decades for a sequel, and they won't have to wait that much.
Space fighters are hard. Like, spacecraft, aircraft, fighting games is hard as fuck to me. And I mean that as the level of difficulty. Like, I just can't get a handle on it. It's like fucking, it's like Rocket League, but worse.
Longer. Homeworld 3 takes place even further in the future and will shake up the deep space RTS formula with the addition of terrain that'll allow for cover. It's still in space, mind you, but there's just a lot of shit floating around up there now. If you like deep space stuff, but Starfield sounds dauntingly expansive, well, there's also The Expanse, a Telltale series, which is a narrative adventure set in the universe of the hit TV show, and that's on PC.
They said, what'd that tongue do? Hold on. What'd that tongue do, boy? That's how he died too. It's not funny, don't laugh, shut up.
Universe of the hit TV show, and that's on PC and consoles. If you think narrative adventures are a novel idea, well, it's time to unravel a new story with Alan Wake 2, which sees the return of Remedy's author protagonist, but this time around promises to be a proper survival.
Alan Wake. Interesting.
Survival horror. If you're one of the many people who spent thousands of hours hunting and crafting and riding dinosaurs in Ark, you may have thought to yourself at some point, this game is great, but it needs Vin Diesel. Well, you weren't the only one, because Vin Diesel felt the same way, and after playing a shitload of the first game, he not only starring in the sequel.
I'm not even surprised that Vin Diesel is in this. With a family too, that's shit.
Cool. He's also involved with its development as Studio Wildcard's president of Creative Convergence, which means he's also executive producing an Ark animated series. Sure, why not? Another AC franchise getting at least one new entry this year is Assassin's Creed. Longtime fans might be relieved to hear that after the last few games have veered heavily into action RPG
I did play the Assassin's Creed games. Not all of them. I played like 2 of them. And they were cool. They was cool. They kind of lost the essence of what Assassin's Creed was supposed to be. I just never picked it up again.
Territory, Assassin's Creed Mirage is going to scale things back and return to the original game's design pillars of stealth, park.
There you go. Okay, so this game is going back to how it was before they fucked it.
Core and assassinations. The setting, 9th century Baghdad. Pinocchio fans, if such a thing actually exists, have had a pretty busy couple of years. Hot on the trail of Disney and Del Toro's feature film takes on that dishonest but lovable wooden boy comes Lies of P. This action RPG retells the original.
This shit look fire. This shit is coming out sometime this year. Okay, I need to put that in my notes. Lies of P. This shit look fire as hell. This is the type of game I play. No, it's not. But I'm gonna play this one.
Original 19th century fairy tale in the form of a fast-paced action RPG a la Bloodborne, and yes, you'll be able to tell lies. Marvel's Spider-Man was one of the best-selling games on PS4, so unsurprisingly, it's getting a follow-up.
But it's automatic. Miles Morales is another game I still have to play. I haven't played it. I'm so glad. I think Marvel Spider-Man 2 doesn't come out until like later on in the year, like at the end, towards the end of the year. So I have a lot of time to play Miles Morales before that game comes out.
Will be exclusive to PS5. After seeing how much Insomniac Games was able to do with the new hardware and Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart, we are dying to see what new tricks our friendly neighborhood wall crawler has in store for us in the sequel. A whole bunch of beloved horror movie licenses have found new life in the asymmetrical multiplayer genre, and joining the ranks of Friday the 13th, Predator, Evil Dead, and Killer Clowns from Outer Space is the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Based squarely in the era of the 1974 slasher classic, the game will have one team playing as meddling teens who have to, you know, not get murdered, and the other team will be playing as not just Leatherface, but his entire messed up family too. And there you have it! That's a whole bunch of games that are coming out in 2023, and it's not even all of them, because a whole bunch of them we don't even know about quite yet. But I know a cool website you can keep an eye on if you like video games. It's called IGN.com. 2023 is going to be a doozy. I'll see you around.
He just plugged his own shit. There's a website you can follow to keep updated with everything. When I see you, I promise you it's on site. Shouldn't have disrespected the sword and hat like that, bro. When I find you, it's a wrap. There's a good chunk of games coming out in the next few months. I'm excited to play a lot of them. I'm going to start off, since Hogwarts Legacy isn't out yet, I'm going to start off with Star Wars Jedi. Start that game over and then finish it completely. Yeah, I can't wait for the rest of these games to come out, for real. Excited.